In this video, we're going to go over how to generate contour buffer strips within the watershed. Contour buffer strips are strips of prairie grass or other perennial vegetation placed along topographic contours, and they are used to intercept overland flow and sediment from running off into natural waterways. They can be placed at a certain spacing along the slope or at the foot slope. The concept is similar to terracing, though slopes are usually the reason for distinguishing between contour buffers or terraces, where terraces are commonly used in steeper sloped areas. The NRCS has suggested certain spacing for terraces within a field, and we have used these recommendations and slightly altered them for siting contour buffer strips in the appropriate spacing for them within the ACPF. By finding the third quartile slope within each field, we determine which possible contour intervals will be applied to that field. There are three options. The contour interval selected will result in a spacing approximately equal to the NRCS recommendations shown before. You can see below the math that is done to calculate the appropriate spacing for each contour buffer strip. So the ACPF tool begins to place contour buffer strips by first masking out 4 to 15% slopes by fields within agricultural land. This does not include pasture. The mask is smoothed by a majority filter, so that way holes within the mask are filled. Contours are then generated within each field using the defined contour interval that was based on the slope of that field. Concentrated flow paths greater than 2 acres in the drainage area are buffered by 10 meters and removed from the contour buffer strip output. That way the contour buffer strips do not intercept flow paths that would hold too much flow for the strip to intercept. Only contours greater than 100 meters in length are maintained and then added to the output. This output is then buffered to a user specified width, which as a default, we provide 15 feet. So to generate our contour buffer strips, we'll go to our Precision Conservation Practice Siting Toolset and open up the Contour Buffer Strips tool. We'll input the Field Boundary Feature class and see that our slope and slope table automatically populate. Unfilled DEM is the new DEM. Our flow accumulation roster is automatically added. We have a z-factor of 0.01. I'm going to keep the 15 feet buffer strip width suggestion. Feel free to edit this if you see fit. And then the output we're going to get is contour buffer strip CBS. And hit OK to let it run. All right, once the tool has finished running, we can look at our result. I'll give them some more color to make them stand out. And we can see that quite a few have been placed throughout the watershed. We'll notice that in flatter areas of the watershed, say here and here, we don't have as many. But along these slopes that we can see in our hillshade, we do have more contour buffer strips sited, which makes sense. And if we look into the attribute table, we can see that we can associate them by field boundary ID, and then we also get the mean slope that the contour buffer strip intersects. Each buffer strip also has a contour associated with it, and this is in centimeters. In certain areas within this watershed, we can see that some terraces already exist by looking at our hillshade. You can see them here as grooves, and that some of our contour buffer strips that were sited land very close to where they're already placed. There's a chance that some of these buffer strips may actually be better implemented as terraces. If we go into the symbology, we can start to classify them by the slope that they're intersecting. So we can choose to symbolize them by the mean slope field. And then if we classify and change our classes to 2, we can basically create a breakpoint, where I know that slopes of 10% or higher are usually more suitable for terraces. So I'm going to change this lower value to 10, hit OK. And then to make it stand out, I'm going to make these bright yellow. And this is what will be more suitable for terraces. And then my contour buffer strips, I'll just make a red. Apply, okay. And then if we zoom out, we can see that there are a few contour buffer strips, say here and here, that may be better suited for terraces. Here's a brief recap of what we did to place contour buffer strips within the watershed. If you'd like to learn more about potential benefits of reduced runoff volume and improved water quality from contour buffer strips, please see the studies conducted in Iowa listed at the last bullet.